Hello everyone, myself Dr. Aditya Gupta. In this video, I wanted to talk to you about medicine for NEET PG from two different perspectives. First is someone who's studying in their final prof, and next is someone who's studying in their, he's an intern and a post-intern, right now preparing for the November INI or for the January NEET PG. You have 4 months, and how do you go about medicine as far as NEET PG or INI is considered? And for a final prof student. So the advice to my final prof student is ki you should actively restrict medicine. Dekho, medicine is so vast ki kabhi complete nahi hone wali. This is one thing that you should get inside your head. Focus on, trying to restrict ki ab isse zyada nahi padhna. Nahi to there's no depth, there's no end to the depth in medicine. You know, so from what I, being very blunt with you, there's no need to study the entire Harrison as a final year student. That's something which a medicine PG should do. Medicine PG karoge to, medicine PG ho, to Harrison padhoge na. Abhi you should in fact, a good book for you probably would be CMDT or something on those lines. In fact, I would recommend you guys to watch one of my previous video, how to study medicine, in which I have told is that you don't really need to watch 250 videos. From what I know, from what I recollect, from what I see from my juniors, is that irrespective of whichever app they are using, almost everyone ends up using PrepLadder for medicine because it is, he has made the medicine a bit more concise. He hasn't expanded into the vastness of medicine. Should restrict medicine. Like, itni zyada medicine padhne ki bhi koi requirement nahi hai. But now coming to the more important part as far as your, November INI specifically is considered. And this is something which I posted as far as my Instagram is considered. Follow me on Instagram. I'll say that reading medicine for post-graduation is a scam. The reason I'm saying this is because you should rather focus on path and pharma, jo tumhe waise bhi karne hi hai. Because if your path and pharma focus is good and your path and pharmacology are strong, you can actually solve 70 to 80% questions of your medicine. So the things that you need to focus on medicine are not the normal medicine that you keep on thinking about, your SLE, your hematological disorders. They can actually be solved with the help of pathology and pharmacology. Rather, the focus in medicine should be on the topics, especially on emergencies. Emergencies पे focus होना चाहिए, ECG पे focus होना चाहिए, again related to emergencies, acute coronary syndromes हो जाएंगे, any abnormal ECG essentially is an emergency, on acid-base balance, again an emergency, the core medicine topics, ये सर मैं नहीं बोल रहा हूँ, this is something which has been reiterated by each and every topper, that reading medicine towards the end of the exam, towards one and a half month, instead you should focus on pathology and pharmacology and on core medicine topics. Listen to these two clips by my juniors, Dr. Sanil and Dr. Richa, both got all in top 20 ranks in this recent INI, telling the same thing.
उसको बस ये कि efficiently करना है. Also, medicine is more or less linked with pathology and pharmacology and physiology. In तीन subjects का मिश्रण है मतलब more or less I would say. So if you have a nice hold on these subjects, so anyways most of your medicine is covered.
जैसे medicine जैसे subject है. When you read pathology, physiology, pharmacology, ये सारे subjects पढ़ने में तुम्हारे medicine के basics बहुत clear हो जाते हैं. फिर medicine में पढ़ने में there is last few days में medicine पढ़ने का इतना importance नहीं है जितना physiopath and pharma.
So basically both of them what they have been trying to emphasize is focus on path pharma. Medicine अगर करनी है तो emergency medicine कर लो, थोड़े updates कर लो, because emergency medicine will cover. So emergency medicine, now you will ask me topics कहाँ से देखूँ? So I think PrepLadder में ये सारे के सारे topics एक जगह दिए हुए हैं. So it can be two scenarios: someone who's using PrepLadder for preparation, or someone who's not using PrepLadder for preparation. It doesn't really matter for that matter. But what happens is कि बस ये emergency module के में जाके ये सारे के सारे topics जरूर देख लो. ठीक है कि ये टॉपिक्स हैं. सो यहाँ पे BLS, ACLS, ECG, ARDS, ABG analysis, simplified, flow volume curve, spirometry. Like मैंने बस एक तो बेसिक लिस्ट बनाई है, मैंने ऑब्वियसली पूरा नहीं निकालने वाला था मैं. सो ये टॉपिक्स ही तुम्हें पता चल जाएंगे ओके ये टॉपिक्स जो है इमरजेंसी मेडिसिन के हैं मुझे पढ़ने हैं, ECG, ABG प्लस दीज टॉपिक्स, एंड दिस विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू अ लॉट एज फार एज INI इज कंसिडर्ड. लेट्स अस्यूम यू आर समवन हू इज एक्चुअली यूजिंग PrepLadder फॉर योर प्रिपरेशन. आई वुड आस्क यू टू सॉल्व दिस क्यू बैंक, आई वुड आस्क यू टू सॉल्व दिस प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस दैट आर रिलेटेड, मोर इंपॉर्टेंटली, most importantly previous year questions that are related to this, and along with that the Q-Bank related to this. Dr. Deepak Mara, Dr. Swati, anesthesia and medicine both have come together to do this, so that's a great thing. Even if you're not someone, topics to zarur dekh lena, so that's something that you can use. Just kholo topics dekho and kar lo, agar hai to use kar lo. So this is my advice for someone who's preparing for this November INI specifically. Reading medicine is a scam in my opinion. Focus more on pathology and pharmacology. Along with, agar medicine padhni hai, to emergency medicine pe zyada focus hona chahiye. On reading ABG, VBG. And agar tumhe dekhna bhi hai, to inki videos tum dekh sakte ho understanding badhane ke liye. But don't focus on doing 250 hours of videos. Time waste hai. Theek hai? Thank you and have a nice day.